Hello, welcome to another new session of Shilognas Bioblog. Today I will discuss about bacterial endospore. Please like, share and subscribe my channel. What is bacterial endospore? What is its composition and why bacterial endospore is generated? The process by which bacterial cell is converted into endospore is known as sporulation. Sporulation occurs when bacteria undergoes a very hard and tough situation. যখন ব্যাকটেরিয়া কোনো প্রতিকূল পরিস্থিতির মধ্য দিয়ে যায় তখনই কিন্তু ব্যাকটেরিয়ার মধ্যে একটা এন্ডোস্পোর তৈরি হয়, কোনো একটা ব্যাকটেরিয়া এন্ডোস্পোর ফর্ম করে। আবার যখন সেই প্রতিকূল পরিস্থিতি থেকে পরিস্থিতি পুনরায় স্বাভাবিক হয় তখন আবার ব্যাকটেরিয়া সেই এন্ডোস্পোর থেকে নর্মাল ভেজিটেটিভ সেলে রিভার্ট ব্যাক করে। সেই এন্ডোস্পোর থেকে ভেজিটেটিভ সেলে রিভার্ট ব্যাক করার সেই পদ্ধতিটাকে বলা হয় জার্মিনেশন। ব্যাকটেরিয়াল এন্ডোস্পোর এতটাই শক্তপোক্ত এবং এত হার্ড অ্যান্ড টাফ যে কোনো প্রতিকূল পরিস্থিতি এমনকি রেডিয়েশন, হাই টেম্পারেচার সমস্ত কিছু কিন্তু টলারেট করে ব্যাকটেরিয়াল এন্ডোস্পোর টিকে থাকতে পারে। সেজন্য ব্যাকটেরিয়া সবসময় প্রেফার করে যখন ব্যাকটেরিয়া কোনো প্রতিকূল পরিস্থিতির মধ্য দিয়ে যায় তখন ব্যাকটেরিয়া এন্ডোস্পোর ফর্মেশন করে। তো কেন ব্যাকটেরিয়ার এন্ডোস্পোর এত হার্ড অ্যান্ড টাফ? এটার একমাত্র কারণ হলো ব্যাকটেরিয়ার এন্ডোস্পোর তৈরি হয় ক্যালসিয়াম ডিপিকোলিনেট দিয়ে। এই ক্যালসিয়াম ডিপিকোলিনেটের উপস্থিতির জন্যই কিন্তু ব্যাকটেরিয়াল এন্ডোস্পোর এত হার্ড অ্যান্ড টাফ। ব্যাকটেরিয়াল এন্ডোস্পোর ইজ ফাউন্ড মেইনলি ইন গ্রাম পজিটিভ ব্যাকটেরিয়া লাইক ব্যাসিলাস, ক্লস্ট্রিডিয়াম, স্পোরোসার্সিনা এটসেট্রা। বাট দের আর সাম মেনি মোর ব্যাকটেরিয়াল স্পিসিস হুইচ ক্যান ফর্ম এন্ডোস্পোর। Bacterial endospores are very dormant, tough and non-reproductive structure produced by the above-mentioned bacteria. It can help the bacteria to survive any stressed condition. Endospore enable bacteria to lie dormant for extended period of time. The process by which endospore is formed is known as sporulation. Now the question is that why some bacteria produce endospore and when the endospores are produced? When bacteria undergo stress condition or unfavorable condition, then they produce endospore. Stressed condition means very low water availability, means dehydration, reduced carbon and nitrogen source, etc. Spores are resistant to heat, UV rays, gamma ray, desiccation and chemical disinfectants, antibiotics, drying, boiling, etc. Chemical disinfectants means hydrogen peroxide, bleaching powder, etc. Now the question is why the endospores are so resistant. Endospores are so resistant because of the presence of calcium dipicolinate. It stabilizes endospores DNA. And small acid soluble proteins which function as a carbon and nitrogen source of DNA in endospore. The small acid-soluble proteins are known as SASP. And another reason is dehydration of endospore. The cortex removes water from the interior of the endospore osmotically, and that's why dehydration makes the endospore so resistant. And DNA repair enzymes. So these are the four main factors why the endospores are so resistant. Next, other bacteria which can form endospore. The other bacteria apart from Bacillus clostridium, the other bacteria which can form endospore are Actinomyces, Coxiella, Disulfotomaculum, Halobacillus, Sporobacter, Thermobacillus, Thermoalkalibacillus, etc. Now, the diseases formed by bacterial endospore. Which diseases are formed by bacterial endospore? Those are anthrax, tetanus, gas gangrene, botulism, pseudomembranous colitis, etc. Endospores can be seen by endospore staining, that is Schaefer-Fulton staining. The next point is position of endospore. According to the position, bacteria can be divided into four: central, subterminal, terminal and lateral. The position of endospore varies from
bacteria to bacteria, and it is very important for bacterial identification. The position of the endospore is very important. The position of endospore is very important for bacterial identification. The first picture is central. When the endospore is situated at the middle portion of the bacteria, then it is known as central endospore, at the center of the bacteria. Then subterminal. Subterminal endospores are those which are present between two extremes, usually seen far enough towards the poles but close enough to the center, so as not to be considered either terminal or central. Third is terminal. Terminal endospores are seen at the poles of the cell. And lateral endospores seen occasionally, and it is at one side of the cell. Parts of endospore. I have already told you that endospores can be seen by Schaefer-Fulton method. It is a staining procedure. The different parts of an endospore are exosporium, spore coat, spore cortex, and core wall. So let's see what is exosporium. A thin, delicate covering that is often present outside the spore. The external part is known as exosporium in the diagram. Then spore coat. It lies beneath the exosporium, just under the exosporium. You can see that spore coat in pink line. It is composed of several protein layers. It is impermeable and responsible for spores resistant to chemicals, because it is composed of calcium dipicolinate or dipicolinic acid. The next part is cortex. It occupies as much as half of spore volume. It is next to spore coat. You can see here what is the cortex, where it is situated, just beneath the spore coat. It occupies as much as half of the spore volume. It is next to spore coat. It is made up of peptidoglycan, that is less cross-linked than that in vegetative cell. And the last part is spore cell wall. It is inside cortex and surrounds the protoplast or core. The core has normal cell structure such as ribosome and a nucleoid, but it is metabolically inactive. Just see here in the innermost part, that is spore cell wall. Discuss the steps of endospore formation. The steps are as follows. The first step is axial filament formation, that is stage 1. The adjustment of the genetic material of the bacterial cell in the accurate center plane. Here, two enzymes are involved, RAKE-A and DIV-4-A. Actually, in this stage, the cell replicating and stretching the DNA into a long axial filament that spans the length of the cell. Just see in the picture, the DNA is almost stretched from one end to another end of the cell. The second stage is septa formation, stage 2. A septum known as four-spore septum is formed as a result of infolding of the plasma membrane into the cell lumen. Its creation causes a small segment of DNA to detach from the remaining genetic material. Septa formation, that means in this stage, the bacterial cell is divided into two parts. A stage, bacterial cell ta duto part divided hoye jacche. The former part is known as four spore, which is smaller, and the larger part that is known as mother cell. And most importantly, the two compartment, the cell is divided into two compartments. Two compartment contains a chromosome. Separately, two chromosomes. The third part is four spore engulfment, or stage 3. The newly formed immature spore is entirely engulfed by the membrane of the mother cell as it proceeds to grow. The engulfment causes the four spore to be enveloped by an intermembrane space and two plasma membrane. Here, the four spore, which is separated from the mother cell, in the third stage, that four spore is engulfed or it is entered into the mother cell. The fourth stage is cortex formation, S4 stage. The inner membrane space between the two membranes give rise to the formation of this cortex. At this stage, the accumulation of dipicolinic acid and calcium in larger quantities is observed, and the mother cell chromosome is disappeared or destroyed at this stage. This is very important, and this is a characteristic feature of the fourth stage, S4 stage. A cortex is made up of thick peptidoglycan layer, which is placed between the two membranes surrounding the four spore protoplast. This cortex will be important in providing heat resistance and maintaining dormancy to the spore. Next stage is, or fifth stage is, protein coat formation, stage 5. The cortex of the hence formed spore is covered with a protein coating layer. Layers of coat protein are deposited at the outer membrane. The sixth step, spore maturation, stage 6. The cell turns inactive metabolically and the core turns increasingly dehydrated. Stage 6 completes the development of spore resistance to heat and chemical insults. This last stage includes the synthesis of dipicolinic acid in the mother cell and its uptake into the core of the spore. Dipicolinic acid is important in maintaining dormancy and in promoting spore dehydration, a characteristic that makes the spore heat resistance. Endospore formation is mother cell release spore. The mother cell called sporangium release the mature spore into the environment. Spores are resistant to many environmental stresses that would kill vegetative cells. The nature of this resistance is due to spore having only 10 to 30% of the vegetative cell's water content. In the picture, in the diagram, you can see that the mother cell wall is burst out and the mature endospore is released in the environment. And this is the complete steps, the 7 steps, which are very important for endospore formation. Germination. Reactivation of the endospore occurs when conditions are more favorable and involves germination. Even if an endospore is located in plentiful nutrients, it may fail to germinate. Germination involves the dormant endospore starting metabolic activity and thus breaking hibernation. It is characterized by rupture or absorption of spore coat, swelling of the endospore and an increase in the metabolic activity and loss of resistance to environmental stress. That means the endospore's dormancy is broken down and the endospore is going to be metabolically active. Endospore possesses 5 times more sulfur than vegetative cells. This excess sulfur is concentrated in spore coats. And amino acid cysteine. This amino acid helps to in the supply of sulfur in spore coat. The macromolecule for maintaining the dormant state has a protein coat rich in cysteine, stabilized by sulfur-sulfur linkages. A reduction in these linkages has the potential to change the tertiary structure, causing the protein to unfold. This conformational change in the protein is thought to be responsible for exposing active enzymatic sites necessary for endospore germination.